Hello, party people. This is Michele Lamberti speaking. Welcome to the new game of the day. This one is going to be another Queen's Gambit declined in our series. This one is going to be Donna, who was a Dutch player. Against Dunkelblum, I guess he was a German player. This game was played in Beverwijk in the Netherlands in 1964. And we'll see the Queen's Gambit declined. Kind of terrorist defense. And let's see how it went. You see c4, c5. Knight to c3, knight to f6, knight to f3, knight to c6. e3, e6, d5, and the game has transposed after d5 into Queen's Gambit declined with a terrorist defense. And here we see a quiet variation. This is basically the symmetrical variation of the terrorist defense. We see cd4, ed4, black captures on c4, and white recaptures with his bishop on c4. One of the reasons that I wanted to show you this game is that we will see a lot of typical maneuvers here in this game, maneuvers that you should know if you play or would like to play the Queen's Gambit declined with white. Black plays the normal bishop e7, white castles, black castles, white plays rook fe1, and black here plays pawn to b6. And you have two ideas basically. You can play bishop to b7, which we saw also in the last game, or maybe you can play, if you have time, a5, and then bishop to a6 with the idea of exchanging this bishop. But white plays his queen to d3. And the idea is that he wants to iron here this diagonal. And now we see bishop to b7. We see bishop g5 by white, which is by far here the best move. Black plays h6, and white drops the bishop to f4. One idea of bishop g5 was that after playing h6, this is a little weakness here. You can always use it to attack, and the bishop here is not the only reason for playing bishop to g5 was to provoke h6, and the bishop has done his job. We see rook f to e8, rook a to d1, and rook a to c8 by black. And basically everything is developed here. The kings are relatively safe, and from now on it's basically you are on your own. You should know your maneuvers, you should know what to do, and especially you should know what not to do, which you can see here demonstrated by black. And here white plays the typical maneuver c4 to a2. This is twofold, or has twofold ideas. Basically, you get the bishop out of the danger zone. If black, for example, plays his knight to a5, then you would attack, and you would have here the rook eyeing down. So white avoids this. And the second idea is to play a to b1 and to harass here the queen, the black king. And this is an idea that black has to defend against. You cannot simply ignore it, which is what black did here in this game. He played a bad move. He played here knight to b8, which is complete disaster. Here in this position, basically, you have two good moves. You can play bishop to d6. And exchanging this one, or you can play bishop to f8, which would reinforce Black's king side, and you would open up here a little bit space for the rook. But okay, he played knight to b8, and now what would you do with white? How would you punish it? It's not an an immediate tactical solution, but it's a very good positional move. White here played is knight to e5, and in queen pawn's opening, whenever you have the possibility to play your knight from f3 to e4 e5, then do it. This is basically never wrong, and it puts a lot of pressure on the black on black's position, and here he can do it for free. One of the protector of e5 is gone, and now basically you get this e5 square for your knight for free. So this was a very bad move, and now he realizes, okay, I have to defend, and he plays the good defensive move bishop f8, and white continues with his attack. You can play this basically in on autopilot. He plays bishop a2 to b1, and if this piece moves, then it's a checkmate. So black has to be very, very careful what he does. And he plays bishop a6. This is not the best move, but already black is here running out of ideas. He wants to break up here this this battery. So he plays a6. And now we realize why he played his knight to b8, because he wanted to reinforce a6 so that bishop a6 can be played, but he lost basically three tempos, and the position is clearly better now for black. And as you can see, white just retreats. He doesn't even have to go to the king side. He can retreat. So complete fail from black. And here black panicked and played the idiotic move g5. This is has written disaster all over it. I mean, you have threats against your king, and then you weaken the position. I mean, black could or white could even play bishop g3, and then go for f4 or h4 and still winning. This is like complete disaster move, and white punishes immediately. He plays the right move. He sacrifices his knight on f7, and now what do you do? You have to take, and now the queen comes in, and you have one square, and what a beautiful square, basically surrounded by white pieces. And here basically white made a move, and black resigned. Oh no, it was a second move. White could have played d5, and then it's game over, but he played his bishop to e5, which is also a good move. Black can't do anything. Black tries to reinforce, and believe it or not, this is a mate in 4 now. You just play your bishop, pardon your knight to d5. You have to take, otherwise it's a checkmate. You play check, it's a double check, so king has to move, only move. You give another check. Notice that black has no escape squares. No, the queen doesn't allow black to play c6, and c7 isn't possible. So you have to go back, and now this is made. A complete disaster. I wanted to show you this game. First of all, for the maneuver here with c4, a2 and b1. And that in this kind of positions, even if the positions look quiet, you don't have time to lose, and you can't make silly moves with the pawn in front of your king. This is not possible. So you, if you have to play solid as black, and yeah, you in this kind of positions where the knight is on e5, you always have to check if those sacrifices on f7 are possible. But I think, okay, this is let's look at some variations. What if black plays this move here? Okay, then you just you have tons of moves here. I mean, you can even play this one here. Good luck defending this. I mean, after taking, this is just lost here. The queen comes in and notice that black has no good squares. No? Let's look at the variations after d5. Okay, what do you do? Let's look at some variation with the engine. Okay, he wants to take. And then the problem is after taking, what do you do? If you move your queen, then comes queen f7 with mate. So you have to give up here your queen, and this is just bullshit. So I mean, let's see what happens after knight captures on d5. I guess, yeah, it's mate. So you have to be very, very careful what you're doing to your king structure. Basically, here black ruined it by itself, and then white helped ruin it. Amazing. Yeah, you should study this attack where you see a lot of common ideas that you see in a lot of games. Yeah, I hope that helped. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.